Greetings and salutations, guys, gals, and transvestites. It's me, super savage, super sexy, WauwautosaTufGuy bodybuilding and figure skating guy. And I'm here to come at you raw and hard. Whoa, Nelly, with my Friday video on something that has been letting me old Puffy Tuff down. What could be making your hero, Tuffosaurus Rex, down in the dumps? What is making me melancholy? Trust me. No, it's not the fact that Roseanne won't send me any more naked pictures. It's not fair! Oh. No, it's not the fact that Netflix won't take my great idea of rebooting Xena Warrior Princess with Caitlyn Jenner and calling it Brucina Warrior Transvestite. That would be a massive hit, right? Right? And it's not the fact that I ran into Arnold Schwarzenegger and, well, he said this to me.
You're one ugly motherfucker.
I was just trying to show him a large hemorrhoid I have on my anus. Why does he gotta be so mean to me? No. The real reason I've been so sorrowful is because the Xbox first party games have been in a massive funk for almost like 14, 15 months. And when I say funk, I don't mean Terry Funk. That was one crazy SOB, huh? Now, before anyone accuses old Tuffy Tuff of being a fan tough boy for PlayStation or Nintendo, I want to make it clear that I am a tough boy fan of good games regardless of the system. I own a PS4 Pro, I own an Xbox One and a Switch, and as well, I have a gaming computer, a gaming PC, if you will. You people. Oh, sorry. I think I need to take a race sensitivity class, you know? Okay. All of you may think I always focus on the PS4 or Switch games for my channel, or my Chan, as I like to call it. But that is because lately, the Xbox first party games have been total disappointments, and I've only been doing this for about 14 months. I wonder if me taking the YouTube seriously and Xbox being down in the dumps has anything in common. Am I Xbox problem? Am I?
I don't think so, Jim.
No. Old Tuffy Tuff is here to fix problems. He fixes all the problems of the world. I know everything about anything, so it couldn't be me. Now, I had been at wit's end with the Xbox games, but what pushed me to the breaking point was State of Decay 2. Xbox had an extremely weak 2017. Other than the greatest platformer of all time, known as Cuphead, and the surprise hit, PUBG. But I really thought 2018 was gonna be when they finally turned their shit around. But when Sea of Thieves released, its hype seemed to die within the first 2 weeks. It was criticized for being boring and repetitive. Hey, didn't I predict it was gonna be those two things? You might as well call me WauwautosaTufGuy. But hey, you can't blame Sea of Thieves. I mean, not every game is gonna be like an episode of Designing Women. Oh! that was Delta Burke. She made me wreck. Ooh, my head is doing somersaults with her hotness. Enough of hotties with the bodies. Back to the Xbox games. Which brings me to today. State of Decay 2 dropped, and it's said to be a buggy mess that is boring and, surprise, repetitive. I just don't understand how this could be crappy, especially when someone on YouTube told me that State of Decay 2 was going to be better than God of War and The Last of Us combined. Yeah, I just don't get it, how some random 11-year-old on YouTube could be wrong. I don't know. State of Decay 2 currently sits at below 70 on Metacritic after almost 70 reviews. Excuse me, almost 50 reviews. Newsflash! 70 nowadays means that your game is below average. When I give a game a 70, it means it's good. Anywho, I honestly don't know why Xbox's first-party games have been such a disappointment as of late. They have the most powerful system on the market, but if Neo Geo has taught us anything back in the 90s, it's that having the baddest boss of a system doesn't mean shit if you don't have the games to back that motherfucker up. Whoa! Was that bad motherfucker Shaft? Hey, I remember you from a Burger King commercial.
Yo, Chef, Burger King has big sandwich combos at just $2.99.
Is that all?
Big sandwich combos at $2.99. Know any better deals?
Not at these prices, baby.
Plain Bro Whopper, double cheeseburger, BK Big Fish, and original chicken sandwich, all with fries and a drink for just $2.99. You dig?
Do it my way.
But I'm talking about $2.99 combos.
I said my way.
That ain't the Shaft I know. The Shaft that old Tuffy Tuff knows said motherfucker at the end of every sentence. Motherfucker!
April Fool, motherfucker.
Now, from February 2016 to February 2017, Xbox was doing quite well with releases such as Quantum Break, Gears of War 4, Halo Wars, and Forza, plus excellent timed exclusives like Rise of the Tomb Raider and City Skylines. But after that date, it was like the system went into its slumber. Games were getting pushed back like Crackdown 3, they were losing timed exclusives like Shadow of the Tomb Raider, and games that were released were just major disappointments like the recent State of Decay 2 and Sea of Boring Thieves. Then taking into account games like God of War, Persona 5, Horizon Zero Dawn, Zelda Breath of the Wild, and Mario Odyssey were releasing for the PlayStation and Switch, and it made Xbox look even worse, and it killed me because Xbox has an incredible treasure trove of franchises that they aren't taking advantage of. So with big bad E3 in just 3 short weeks, I think the Xbox needs to come hard, like Tuffy Tuff with his shirt off and his anaconda hanging out. Whoa, Nelly! Now that is the real deal! First off, we need Halo 6, and it has to be better than Halo 5. How does Halo 6 be better than Halo 5? Well, that is easy! Halo developers, you just need to do better at making Halo. I'm so smart. Smug and pompous face. Secondly, Xbox needs to surprise us guys, gals, and transvestite gamers with huge cult following games like Fable and Alan Wake. And for the love of Pete, make the Fable game like Fable 1 and 2 and not like motherfucking 3! Thirdly, or should I say thricely, that's me being sophisticated. Sophisticatedness and Tuffy Tuff goes hand in hand, huh? Okay, now as I was saying, We need actual release dates for Crackdown 3 and Ori and the Will of the Wisps. After 3 years of delays, are people even excited about Crackdown 3 anymore? The game went from one of my most anticipated games to I could care less about it. You know, it keeps getting pushed back, and then they're taking the destruction out of the single player. That was its shtick. That was its selling point. The fourth thing I think Xbox needs to do is have either exclusive access or a long-timed access to strong third-party games. Left 4 Dead 2 was one of my favorite 360 games of all time. And with Valve announcing they are getting back into making games, wouldn't Left 4 Dead 3 be an amazing game for the Xbox One X to kill it with? Well, also, remember when Mass Effect 1 and 2 were only on the 360 for like 1, 2, 3 years, maybe more? Those are timed exclusive that most people have to play right away, and they won't want to wait for the ports to the PS4 or Switch. We were all we had left. And finally, the Xbox needs to come at us with some new franchises, some new IPs. I think that Cuphead was the best fucking Xbox game ever made on all three systems combined. And you know what? That was an indie game. It was a little indie gem. If you could put your whole resources into a huge game, just think what you could do with the Xbox One X. It'd be incredible. Look at what Horizon Zero Dawn was able to do. Look at what Death Stranding and Days Gone are attempting to do. Even if those games don't turn out to be legendary, they are giving us gamers something to look forward to and be excited about. And just to clarify, I think those two games will be amazing. Toffee Tough's seal of approval. All the Xboxes will go down in history as being all amazing game consoles, and the Xbox One X is the most powerful system on the market today by a good margin. So there is no reason for them to be lagging behind PS4 and Switch. The PlayStation has always been my go-to system, but the Xbox was always right next to it, and I have some amazing memories of playing that black and green SOB. Hey, that reminds me of what it looked like the last time I took a major poopy. Ooh. Xbox, focus on making great games to go with that amazing piece of hardware so we gamers can be showered in riches of games and not just golden showers. Yeah. Huh? Wait, what? Yeah, I like getting peed on. Who doesn't while they game? I guess we don't judge me! Okie dokie, human. So there you have it. I love the Xbox. I really do. But I have been insanely in the membranely disappointed with it in its last 12 to 15 months. So what are all your opinion on Xbox's games for 2017 and 2018 and beyond? Do you think they will bring it like The Rock for E3?
Just bring it, bitch!
Or will they be like Gilbert?
Oh, wait a minute! God.
He's back! It's not Goldberg, it's Gilbert!
Gilbert looks as phenomenal as he ever did! Look at the physique on that man!
He looks 80! Must be taking...
Is Xbox done this gen? And are they going to focus on the next Xbox? Tell me what you think, because I need your knowledge to make my knowledge even more knowledgeable, and I will be the most knowledgeable person in the world of knowledge. I'm smart. Aw, shucks. It's that time I looked at my imaginary watch I've never had on. I'm gonna miss all you. I mean, why do you all have to leave? Can't you all just come to my estate and sleepy-eyed my couch? If you do, you will be of the sleep next to Logan Paul. He sleeps behind my couch. I hear he's a big star, but what do I know? You can sleep with me, old Logan Paul, behind Tuffy Tuff's couch! So you will come spend time with old Puffy Tuff? We can even have a sleepover. Okay, well, just ask me for my contact info and let me know when you can come, and I'll have someone pick you up in my private jet. The sassy Svetlana, the Russian anus buster. Yeah, that's my jet's name. Okay, well, I'll be waiting for you, fake watch. Roll the doggone credits.
That place might be home worthy.
Keep going.
Yeah, you sit that motherfucker.
I bet you won't hit a motherfucker, hit a motherfucker.